Welcome back, fellow scientists.
I'm glad I wore my walking shoes.
Today, we're going to be learning about what animals eat for energy, and what better place to do that than my local zoo?
Plus, the zoo sells some of my favorite snacks, too. Ready to embark on this virtual safari with me? Let's head on in.
By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to explain that all animals eat food to acquire energy. You'll also be able to compare and contrast herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Let's get into it. All living things need energy to survive. Most animals are consumers, which means they get energy by eating or consuming food. We could group animals into three categories based on what type of food they eat: herbivores, carnivores, or omnivores. The prefix herbi means plants, so herbivores are animals that get their energy by eating plants. That doesn't mean all herbivores have the same diet, though. They may consume fruit, a staple of the fruit bat's diet, or they may eat seeds, as is the preference of the red squirrel. They may prefer nectar, a favorite of the hummingbird, or they may be like the capybara, eating a combination of many different plant parts. Whichever plant parts herbivores consume, they want to get as much energy out of their food as possible. But plant products can make that difficult. They may be tough to get into, like seeds with hard shells, or it just may be difficult to get to the yummy parts, as is the case with bamboo shoots. To get the most out of their meals, herbivores have certain physical adaptations, or body features, that help them to best survive in their environment. You can often identify an herbivore by the shape of their teeth. Many herbivores have large, flat molars designed to crush and grind plant matter. This helps the herbivore to get more nutrients from the plants. Even with molars, plants can be difficult to digest. To help with this, herbivores will often have specialized digestive systems. Cows, for example, have four different stomach chambers, each one performing a different step in breaking down their food. Seed-eating birds have an organ called a gizzard, which contains small stones used to grind the seeds into smaller pieces. Another common physical adaptation among herbivores is the placement of their eyes. Many herbivores have eyes located on the sides of their head, like goats and deer. This adaptation, though, is not because of their diet. Instead, it's because herbivores often have many predators, or animals that want to eat them. Animals that are often prey, or are eaten by other animals, benefit from this eye placement because it provides a wider field of vision, making it easier to keep an eye out for predators.
We're at the enclosure for some of my favorite herbivores, giraffes.
Giraffes use their long necks to feed on the leaves of trees.
Yummy.
Can you think of any herbivores that we've not mentioned yet? Pause the video here and record your thoughts in your guided notes. The next group of animals are carnivores. The prefix carni means meat, so carnivores are organisms that eat meat, like other animals, for energy. Like herbivores, the diets of carnivores can vary. Some carnivores, like otters, eat fish. Some, like hawks or wolves, consume small mammals, and others, like echidnas, eat insects. Because carnivores consume other animals for food, they mainly rely on hunting to get their meals. Often, carnivores will have physical adaptations that help them to hunt. For example, many carnivores have long, sharp teeth and strong jaws. This combination helps them to grab their prey, then pierce and tear the flesh. In contrast to many herbivores, carnivores' eyes are typically located on the front of their head. This allows them to focus their sight on one target, helping them to clearly see their prey. Keen eyesight can be critical to a carnivore's hunting success. Some carnivores can spot prey from extremely far away, such as a bald eagle, which can spot a rabbit from 3 miles away.
Carnivores can also have many other physical adaptations that depend on their hunting style. That cheetah, for example, may be lying down now, but it can run incredibly quickly, up to 70 miles an hour. Glad I'm not in that enclosure. So, herbivores get their energy from plants, and carnivores get their energy from meat. With how delicious the food is at the zoo, I'm glad I don't have to choose. I can eat my plant-based popcorn and a meaty corn dog. I guess that makes me an omnivore. Omni means all. So omnivores are organisms that eat both plants and animals for energy. Omnivores have a wide variety of food options, which can be extremely helpful to their survival. Their diverse diets help them to survive in a variety of environments and conditions. If one food source grows scarce, an omnivore can seek out other options. Like herbivores and carnivores, omnivores have physical adaptations to help them get energy. Omnivores are also predators, so they will typically have eyes on the front of their head, like raccoons, foxes, and yes, humans. Because of their combination diet, many omnivores have teeth similar to both carnivores and herbivores. Omnivores often have sharp teeth at the front of their mouth to help grip and tear meat, and they have large flat teeth at the back of their mouth to help grind up plant matter. And we've reached my favorite animal at the zoo, the chimpanzee. Chimpanzees are omnivores too, eating mostly fruits, nuts, and seeds. They're also big fans of insects, like termites. Does it look like he's eyeing my pretzel? Okay, maybe it's time to head out. Can you think of any other animals that eat both plants and animals? Pause the video now and jot down the name of any omnivores you can think of in your guided notes. Let's review everything we've learned about what animals eat. We can categorize animals based on how they get their energy. Herbivores eat plants and plant products like seeds and fruit for energy. Carnivores eat meat, and omnivores eat both meat and plants. No matter what they eat, animals have physical adaptations that help them to get the most energy from their meals. To learn more about what animals eat, be sure to check out the practice questions and activities that go with this lesson. What a great day at the zoo. I am wiped. Maybe I should go back in and grab an ice pop for some more energy. Until next time, remember, science is all around us. See you next time. Hey.